What's up, guys? Tonight I'm going to be playing Pokémon Polished Crystal, which is a ROM hack of Crystal, obviously. And the cool thing about this game is it has a built-in Nuzlocke mode, which I'm going to turn on. And it also has running shoes, which is not a thing in Crystal. I'm going to switch that to Shift, because I feel like it's a little bit more fun that way. And everything else looks good. So let's get started. You woke me up. Will you check the clock for me? What time is it? It is 10:20. Yes. No wonder it's so dark. Sorry to keep you waiting. Welcome to the world of Pokémon. My name is Oak. People call me the Pokémon Professor. Ah, it's Sylveon. That's another thing about this hack. It has like 250 something Pokémon, and it only adds like EV evolutions and Pokémon that are in Gen 1 and Gen 2 that have later evolutions and later gens. It also adds Fairy type, which is kind of interesting. And I want to say it gets rid of a few Pokémon, like Spearow and Hoppip. I can't remember the rest. This world is inhabited by creatures that we call Pokémon. People and Pokémon live together by supporting each other. Some people play with Pokémon, some battle with them. But we don't know everything about Pokémon yet. There are still many mysteries to solve. That's why I study Pokémon every day. I am a boy. And go buy ZLink. Are you ready? Yes. Your very own Pokémon story is about to unfold. You'll face fun times and tough challenges. A world of dreams and adventures with Pokémon awaits. Let's go. I'll be seeing you later. Is there an item? No. Alright. See, if I hold B, I walk a little bit faster. That's kind of helpful. It's the town map. Oh, they use the Gen 4 color scheme. That's kind of cool. Goldenrod Harbor? What else is in here? Bellchime Trail? Glitter Lighthouse? Battle Tower, I think that's in Crystal. Yellow Forest. Quiet Cave? Mount Mortar, that's in there. That's cool. So they've added a few places. Oh, ZLink, you're awake. Your friend Lyra, was just here. She said that our neighbor Professor Ellen was looking for you. I almost forgot, your Pokemon gear is back from the repair shop. Here you go. It's essential if you want to be a good trainer. Oh, the day of the week isn't set. You mustn't forget that. Today is Thursday.
Yes.
No. Do you know how to use your new running shoes? Yes. Aren't they convenient? Who is this? Good evening, ZLink. I'm visiting. ZLink, have you heard? My daughter is adamant about becoming Professor Elm's assistant. She really loves Pokemon.
See if they'd let me buy.
What do you think you're doing? It's dangerous to go out without a Pokemon. Wild Pokemon jump out of the grass on them, blah blah blah. Alright. Oh, they put her theme in here. I like it. has a nice 8-bit remix to it. Well, hello, ZLink. Are you meeting Professor Elm? Let me come with you. He always has interesting things to say about Pokemon. ZLink, there you are. Hello to you too, Lyra. Looking out for your friend? ZLink, I need to ask you a favor. I'm conducting new Pokemon research right now. I was wondering if you could help me. You see, I'm writing a paper that I want to present at a conference. But there are some things I don't... blah, blah, blah. I'd like you to raise a Pokemon that I recently caught. Yes. You're great help. When I announce my findings, I'm sure we'll delve a bit deeper into the many mysteries of Pokemon. You can count on it. Neat, can I raise a Pokemon too? Sure, Lyra. I know you're responsible. Oh, hey, I got an email. Hey, listen. I have an acquaintance called Mr. Pokemon. He keeps finding weird things and raving about his discoveries. Saying that this time it's for real, it is intriguing, but we're busy with our Pokemon research. Wait, I know. ZLink, can you go in our place? Sure. You'll be that Pokemon's first partner. Go and pick one. I'm gonna pick Totodile. Do you want Totodile, the water Pokemon? Yeah, sure. I think that's a great Pokemon too. Let's name it... I don't know, Sir Chompy. Then I'll pick this one. Is that Totodile even a Sir? Mr. Pokemon lives a little bit beyond Cherry Grove, the next city over. It's almost a direct route there, so you can't miss it. Just in case, here's my phone number. Call me if anything comes up. Sweet. If your Pokemon is hurt, you should heal it with this machine. Feel free to use it anytime. Alright, so it was a male. As a Oranberry, I'm gonna change something real quick. ZLink, let's get to know our Pokemon with a battle. This is a different theme too. Thank you. What is that, Gen 6? Sir Chompy grew to level 6. Learned Water Gun. That was an exciting battle. Thank you for the Pokemon, Professor Elm. ZLink, I'll see you later. Have fun on your errand. Thanks, dude. Let's heal. Would you like to heal your Pokemon? Yes. ZLink, I want you to have this. Potions. And even though this is a Nuzlocke, it technically hasn't started right now. Because I don't have any Pokeballs. Another thing that this hack has is physical and special type moves. Like Water Gun is a special type and Scratch is physical. Because normally in Gen 2, like all water type moves are special. So that's kind of cool. What's up, man? How you doing tonight? I'm playing another ROM hack called Polished Crystal, and it's kind of cool because it has its own Nuzlocke mode built in. It's an option I can turn on or off, and it also has running shoes, which you can't normally get in Crystal. How am I doing? I'm doing pretty good, man. It's almost the end of the week, so times are good. But it automatically keeps track of how many encounters you've, or which Pokemon you've encountered on the route. So it hasn't started yet because I don't have Pokeballs, but I'll show you whenever the playthrough actually gets going. And another cool thing is the attacks have physical and special attributes, which normally aren't a thing in Gen 2. So a lot of work has been put into this ROM hack. Figured I'd test it out. Yeah, and I want to say it adds like 100 or so Pokemon, maybe not even that much, but it's only the evolutions of Gen 1 and Gen 2 Pokemon. So like all the Eevee evolutions and Magmar's evolution, and pre-evolutions too. So yeah, it's pretty cool, and it also adds fairy type. My house, thanks for your company. Let me give you a small gift. And if you look at the map over here, it shows new places. Like, there's a Goldenrod Harbor. Belchime Trail. Glitter Lighthouse. And like a whole new area over here. So Cliff Edge Gate. And then Yellow Forest, I don't know what that is. And Quiet Cave. So, kind of excited to get there. Oh, and the Pokemon Yellow Nuzlocke didn't work out too well. Lieutenant Surge just completely destroyed me. Which is kind of sad. Somehow, Butterfree beat him. But at that point, I lost too many good people. Or Pokemon. They just drop right off. Thanks, dude. And this game also has a level curve, so by the end of the game, all the trainers should be at level 100. Because normally all the trainers in Kanto are really weak. Thank you. Hello, hello, you must be ZLink. Professor Elm said that you would visit. Proceed, mystery egg. I was intrigued, so I sent mail to Professor Elm. For Pokemon evolution, Professor Elm is the authority. Even Professor Oak here recognizes that. If my assumption is correct, Professor Elm will know it. Speaking of Oak, did you see the trailer that came out today? That has, like, Oak's cousin, Black Cousin. I'm Oak, Pokemon researcher. I was just visiting my old friend, Mr. Pokemon. I heard you were running an errand for Professor Elm, so I waited here. I understand why Professor Elm gave you Pokemon for this errand. To researchers like Professor Elm and I, Pokemon are our friends. You seem to be dependable. I'm like a 12-year-old kid, dude. I have to get to Goldenrod for my usual radio show. You're returning Professor Elm. Here, your Pokemon should have some rest. I'm depending on you. Thanks, dude. Hello, ZLink. It's a disaster. It's just terrible. What should I do? Please, get back here now. First, I'm gonna go pick this tree. Sir Chompy gained 33 experience points. Thank you. Alright. You got a Pokemon at the lab, what a waste, a wimp like you. Don't you get what I'm saying?
Well,
I too have a good Pokemon. I'll show you what I mean. A Sentret? That's interesting. Let's just keep using Rage. Hopefully it actually attacks me before I kill it. This should do some decent damage on his Chikorita's mount. I wasn't expecting him to already have two Pokemon. I guess he stole some Pokeballs too. And it had a berry. My name's... I'm going to be the world's greatest Pokemon trainer. Alright, dude. Not damaged. Did it automatically heal me? I heard a Pokemon was stolen here. Rule number one, the criminal will always return to the scene of the crime. Oh my, so you're the thief? Hold on, ZLink has nothing to do with it. I saw a red-haired boy spying on the building. You battled a trainer like that? Did you happen to get his name? That darn case slugs. ZLink, I'm glad you understood that you're innocent. Alright, peace out. this, but is it a Pokemon egg? That's incredible. He is superb at seeing the potential of people as trainers. I'm like 12 years old, dude. Closest gym would be the one in Violet City. Before you leave, make sure that you talk to your mom. Where did you get it? Oh wow, that was a wide left. So you're leaving on an adventure. Okay, I'll help you. I know, I'll save money for you. On a long journey, money is important. Sure, you can save my money. Now go on, peace. You can catch wild Pokemon with Pokeballs. Follow me and I'll show you. See, just like that. If you weaken them first, Pokemon are easier to catch. I'll give you these. Good luck. See you. Alright, this is the first Pokemon of the route. Surely Rage won't kill it. At level 2. Yeah, that's what I thought. Gotcha, Rattata was caught. This Pokemon's impressive vitality allows it to live anywhere. It also multiplies very quickly. What to name it? Thank you. let's go up here first. Do y'all give me anything? Different kinds of Pokemon appear past here. If you want to catch them all, you have to look everywhere. You can't climb ledges, but you can jump down from them to take a shortcut. Thanks, dude. Rattata. I already have Rattata. Geodude. That could be useful for this gym. Surely it can withstand a scratch. Yeah, that's what I thought. Sweet. Proud of their sturdy bodies, they bash against each other in a contest to prove whose is harder. Whose what is harder? What to name this dude? Rocky Balboa. Rocky, I'm gonna name him Dwayne. Dwayne the Rock Johnson. We hope to see you again. Alright, did y'all give me anything? When I was walking in the grass, a bug Pokemon poisoned my Pokemon. My Pokemon barely recovered, you should keep an antidote with you. Pokeballs are in stock, now I can catch Pokemon. Hey. Let's buy 10 of those. Like, 2 of those. Alright, moving on. Let's see who I get on this route. Hoot hoot. Wow, that kill, it would be a crit. Aw, oh, that's kind of sad. Oh, well. Spinarak. Too bad I can't catch you, little buddy. Trying to find more Pokemon. Wait, you look weak. Come on. Youngster Joey wants to battle. Good old Rattata. More Pokemon in order to battle better? No, I'm sticking with this one no matter what. Listen, can I get your phone number? Yeah, sure. I really hope he has a level 100 Rattata whenever I face him again. That'd be hilarious. Then you have to battle. Will ZLink change Pokemon? Nah. Instead of a bug Pokemon, I found a trainer. Bugcatcher Dawn sent out Caterpie. Level 3. I should switch Rattata to front. After this. Or Rocky. Probably Rocky. Or Dwayne. In it. Let's see who I encounter on Route 31. Poliwag. I already have water type. That's kind of useless. Alright. You can never have too many Pokemon though, so let's try and catch it. Hopefully it doesn't crit like it did last time. Alright, that's probably a sign that I shouldn't keep attacking it. Shoot. This was so close to... Gotcha, Poliwag was caught. Ratman. Ratman grew to level 3. The swirl on its belly is its inside showing through the skin. It looks clear after it eats. That's kind of sketchy. What to name this thing? Dark cave. If Pokemon could light it up, I'd explore it. ZLink found potion. Let's see what I get here. Hopefully Zubat? Yeah. Level 2. Please, for the love of God, don't kill it. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, I don't even know what to name this thing. Name this thing. During the day, it gathers with others and hangs from the ceilings of old buildings and caves. I'm gonna name it. Hey, what's up, the Iron Gobbler? How are you doing tonight? Do you have any suggestions on what I should name Zubat? Annoy? Funny thing is, though, I really like Crobat, that's one of my favorite Pokemon. But he is annoying, I do agree. Zubats and Golbats are really crappy. I'll name it what my friend told me to name it, Lame Bat. And then I'm going to sweep the Elite Four with it. I'm doing alright. Yeah, unfortunately this is a Nuzlocke, so I can't catch it. Have you heard of Polished Crystal before? This is a ROM hack. And it has a built-in Nuzlocke mode. So, if I wanted to throw a Pokeball at it, it wouldn't let me. Because it keeps track of the Pokemon you've encountered on each route. And it also adds running shoes. So that's kind of helpful. And it also adds like 20 or so new Pokemon. It's mainly just evolutions of Gen 1 and Gen 2. Yeah, it's a Nuzlocke. But like the Eevee evolutions, Magmar, etc. And it also differentiates between physical and special type moves. Because in Gen 2, can you catch it? Can you catch what? I already have a Poliwag, actually. That was a Pokemon I encountered on this route. Let's keep him front. Yeah. Let's see, even if I go to the bag and use a Pokeball, it'll pop up and say, you already encountered a Pokemon here. So even if I wanted to try and catch something, I can't. That's cool, dude. Let's go explore. Pokemon you get in a trade grows quickly, but if you don't have the right gym badge, they will disobey you. Do you have Teddy Ursa? Want to trade it for my Elekid? No. I do not have a Teddy Ursa. A Polish? A Poliwag? Sure. If it happens to be the first Pokemon, that's the only way I can catch it. Otherwise, it won't let me. Youngster Joey. I just battled you, dude. But sure, man, I'll definitely try. Nah, you're good, dude. I caught a few more Pokemon since you've been gone, though. I caught a Geodude. I named him Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Just Dwayne for short. A Rattata, named him Ratman. A Poliwag named Swirly. And a Zubat named Lamebat. So that'll make Kevin happy. And then I'm gonna sweep the Elite Four with nothing but Crobat. But right now I need to train him. Another thing that I noticed about this hack, each sprite on the screen is personalized, like this Totodile. Normally there's not a Totodile. I really do, but Zubat is kind of annoying. I agree. And Golbat sucks. But Crobat. Crobat is Probat. But usually, if you catch a Zubat at level 2, by the time it becomes a Golbat, the very next level becomes a Crobat. So, yeah. I don't even know where the name raider is in this game. Nice, dude. The Iron Gobbler. Oh yeah, deal for real. I don't know if you're here to see this, but it's like programmed in to where I can actually catch this Spinarak, which I think is pretty cool. So even if I wanted to try and catch this, it will pop up and say, you already encountered a Pokemon here. So. Yeah, man, just keep at it. More people will join eventually. Goldenrod, alright. It won't let me. It just pops up with that and then nothing happens. Here, I'm gonna change something real quick. Alright. I put a button on turbo, so I can grind a little bit faster. And I'm actually going to turn music back on. Sweet man, thanks for the follow. It should, yeah, there it goes. Alright. Because the fast forward is going to get kind of annoying. I'll just put on music. Yeah, I really hate playing with fast forward. I try to avoid it whenever I can. I think this dude has nothing but Caterpie. So let's train some of these lower levels. Yeah, I really hate whenever they randomly crit you. Mudslap. No. A Weedle. Yeah. I think I'm only gonna use it for grinding. But once I get out of the shroud, I'll turn it back off. Or stop using it, I should say. One thing that's kind of useful about this hack is poison doesn't kill him. Like, it send it to 1%. And I don't know how I feel about that yet. Kind of makes it a little bit easy. Let's give it only up one, never mind. I guess I'll just keep doing this. Yeah, it's only in the overworld. So in battle it will kill me. It makes it a little bit easier, but I mean, I don't know. Bite? Yes. Yes. Unless I end up losing everyone, then I'll just play it regularly. But I want to say this hack is programmed to say this Zubat was to die, it would stay permanently fainted until I turned off the option in the menu. Even if I take it to the Pokemon Center or put it in the PC, it would always be fainted. So why do you want me to name it Iron? Is there a story behind that? The Poliwag? Ah, that makes sense. Very nice. Recovered from its poisoning. Whenever I get to the name writer, I can change it. I'm gonna make a note of that, actually. I normally stream about 11 o'clock every night. The only night I won't be, I think, is tomorrow night. And that's because I have to work at 6 in the morning the next morning. The Ghastly. I didn't even know that was on this route. Next route I can catch Pokemon at is over here, and I'm not gonna catch anyone over here yet because there's the Sudowoodo over here, and if I was to catch a Pokemon in the grass it would count for this, and I'd rather have this than like a Rattata or something. Y'all give me anything? I was going to snap that tree with my straight arm punch, but I couldn't. I'm a failure. Who are you? I'm Arthur of Thursday. A Hardstone. Pumps it up, blah blah blah. Mr. Earl taught me how to battle with Pokemon. Oh, you're a trainer. I'm guessing this ROM hack also adds new trainers. Yeah. I definitely don't remember Trainer having the Vulpix this early in the game. Mareep? No. Ampharos, the evolved form of Mareep, is also one of my favorite Pokemon. I really like Gen 2. A lot of the evolutions are really cool. Teddiursa, no. Unfortunately, I don't think I'll be able to catch a Mareep because they only appear during the day. And since I stream at 11 o'clock, it'll always be nighttime. So that's kind of lame. But, oh well. Yeah, whenever I was in College Station with Kevin, I caught a shiny Mareep. So, it's just the Mega Ampharos, whenever it's pink, it looks so sick. Yes, it does. If you look at the Pokégear, it'll tell you the time. Right now it's 11:38. There's three different time periods in this game. There is a morning. I could, but I might, since it'll always be nighttime whenever I play this. It's kind of interesting how it stays the actual time even though I'm fast forwarding. Yeah, that's cool. Gen 2 is definitely my favorite. Then I'd probably do Gen 3. Gen 5 is definitely at the end. I really don't like Gen 5. That did no damage. Yeah, Emerald has the most hours I've ever played in a game, or a Pokemon game. Because I think my cartridge has like 450 hours. But there's a lot of stuff to do in Emerald. I wish they'd bring back the Battle Frontier, because that was really cool. Oh crap, that wasn't very smart. Yeah, Wild was actually not too bad. But the thing I didn't like about X and Y is they hold your hand like the entire game. It adds to the story, but it makes it really easy. I really didn't have a problem with X and Y. It's just Gen 5. I really don't like Gen 5. It's like everywhere you go, your friends are like right in front of you. They're like, hey, come this way. Alright, let's go heal Poliwag before it dies. Yeah, when Gen 5 came out, I just didn't play for a while. And then I finally came back to it. It's not all bad. I don't know. It was just different for the time. I really don't have a problem with Gens 1 through 4. I think it had a lot of hand-holding. Black and White 2 was a little bit better than Black and White, because there was more to do. I feel like you get poisoned way too easily in this game. Come on, Nightbot. Don't be that way. Let me turn off Nightbot. Yeah, I think it's set to 3, so I'm gonna bump that up. Because 3 seems really low. Oh, Nightbot. You're good, dude. Yeah. I haven't really messed around with Nightbot much, so a lot of the settings are still the default. Yeah. Hey, there you go. I think there's Ghastly's. Oh crap. Send out Bellsprout. Level 3, that's not too bad. Twitch automatically puts a delay. And if it's more than like 30 seconds, just reset the stream. I usually stream for like 3 hours or so. Got it, sweet. And it's really grew to level 9. It wraps its opponent in its gas-like body, slowly weakening its prey but poisoning it through the skin. Seems kind of rough. I'm gonna name it Caesar. Because for whatever reason, I always name Ghastly Caesar. I don't know why. Nice. Yeah, man, I definitely appreciate you tuning into the stream. It means a lot. Back to grinding to go. I'm already poisoned. Thank you. Found a good Pokemon in Dark Cave. Blah, blah. Yeah. I want to know how it'll work with the legendaries in this game. Suicune and Entei and Raikou. Since they wander from place to place. No, I cannot. Alright, after this dude talks to me. If you look at the map, where I am here, I have to get all the way around to Goldenrod before I can rename it. So, it'll probably be a little while before I can rename Pokemon. Because normally, or later on in the game, I can just go to where the Sudowoodo is over here. And he won't be here. Let me get to him. He won't be here and I can just drop down and the city I need to go to is right there. But because I can't move him yet, I have to go all the way around. Yeah. So I have to do a lot of grinding, which is kind of annoying. Which is why I'm over here just constantly fighting the same Pokemon over and over again. Which I think I'm about to advance to the next part. Should I keep the music or should I go back to the normal game music, in your opinion? Because this hack does add new music and cries. Gotcha. Yeah, I'll try to keep Poliwag alive. Back to the normal playthrough. Yeah, I really like the music in this game. It just gets kind of old sometimes. Paralyze, heal. Stand guard in this tower. Here we express our gratitude to honor all Pokemon. super effective. Wow, this is much slower when you are used to fast forwarding. Yeah, I might just put the music back on. That way I can fast forward. Say the music that's playing right now is actually the music that's supposed to be playing in this tower. I think it's turned on. But yeah, you just do exclamation point, song request, and then whatever you want. Pika girl? I'm not too sure what that is. I want to say you can just do I don't know if that's the right one. Yeah, you're good, dude. Is that the right song? Let's see how much longer this song is. Yeah, I figured it wasn't hardcore. That's the first song that pops up though. Is this the right version? This would have been appropriate whenever I played Pokémon Yellow. Even though Pikachu's really bad in that game, even though the whole game's about him. I'm not sure why this says hardcore. It doesn't seem that hardcore. Alright, who's first? You are indeed skilled as a trainer, as promised. Here's your HM. Hey, what's up, K-Slugs? Doing alright today? Alright, peace out, dude. thanks again for tuning in. Pokemon are not tools of war. He claims to be the elder, but he's weak. He stands to reason. I never lose to fools who babble about being nice to Pokemon. Later, dude. I really couldn't care less about weak Pokemon. Later, dude. Thanks for tuning in, deal for real. Alright, dude. Let me show you my roster of Pokemon. Got Sir Chompy the Totodile, Dwayne the Rock Johnson Geodude, Swirly Poliwag, and I named him Lame Bat. Just for you. That's not gonna stick. Once we get to Goldenrod, that's becoming something different. I thought it'd make you happy. And then Caesar, I don't even know why I named him Caesar. But Caesar the Ghastly. And Ratman. But I'm gonna show you something about this hack. Since I've already caught a Ghastly, or I already caught a Pokemon in this place, if I was to actually try and catch it with a Pokeball, it says you already encountered a Pokemon here. So it adheres to the Nuzlocke rules pretty strictly, which is kind of cool, I think. Thanks, dude. Oh my god, I just want to battle this dude. You remember in Sacred Gold, this dude destroyed me with his, oh, is it Hoot Hoot? Let's see if he does that now. Yeah, he enjoyed it. He says that this is his kind of hack. It's pretty nice, I like it. It adds Lyra or whoever from Gen 4. So she's like your second rival. And it also adds Fairy type. But I don't have any fairy types yet. I just destroyed that Hoot-Hoot, by the way. Sir Chompy is trying to learn what? Scary face? No. Yes. Oh crap, this is a bad idea. Alright, I watched how I did. It doesn't matter. You and your Pokemon should have no problem using this move. Flash. Not really. It's about the same for right now, but whenever I get to Kanto, the levels of everything like jumps way up, and by the end of the game they should all be level 100, the trainers. So right now, it's pretty easy. There's a few new trainers that are harder, but it's really not that bad. And I did a ton of grinding, so... Oh, I think I found his run code on the GitHub. It was under macros. Alright, let's face the gym leader. Hey, you can't challenge Faulkner right now. He's in Dark Cave. That's different. Come back later. Alright. I didn't want to face him anyways. It's a little easier. It has the Gen 6 thing where if you catch a Pokemon you still get experience points. I don't like that. And if I get poisoned and I'm in the overworld, it won't faint my Pokemon. So I don't like that either. Where do I go? Ja, Pidgeot. Normally you don't do this. Normally you can just face him. I'm Faulkner the Violet, Pokemon Gym Leader. I don't explore caves for fun, but that Ursaring was attacking trainers too weak to defend themselves. As a gym leader, it's my job to handle this sort of situation. So you're here to earn a badge. Then meet me at the Violet Gym. Alright, dude. Be right there. I don't even know what I just said. I was saying that the gym leader, this whole thing, like going into this cave to find the gym leader isn't part of Crystal version. So there's some script changes. Oh crap. And I was saying if you get poisoned in battle, whenever you leave battle, it won't kill your Pokemon if you're in the overworld, which is kind of lame. It adds like physical type moves and special type moves, because normally like every single water type move is always going to be special, but in this game it separates the two, which is kind of cool. What else? Oh, if you go to the Pokemon screen, each Pokemon has their own like individualized sprite. Because normally there's not like a little Totodile sprite or a Ghastly sprite. So that's kind of cool. There's a lot of new things. There's new music too, but it doesn't sound good whenever you're just fast forwarding through it. Yeah, the dudes definitely put some work into it. And like, if you go down here, normally this dude or this kid gives you like a Onyx named Rocky or something, but instead he'll trade you Elekid, which is a Gen 4 Pokemon. I got a new M. What do you mean by M? Oh, emulator. Wow, I'm stupid. Yeah. So I can fast forward. I just use the Z button on the GameCube controller. So it works out pretty nice. Yeah, I get what you mean now. Keyword is guts. Let's give this to you. And heal you. Something that I like though is I can sit here and speed it up as much as I want, but the game time stays the same because I've been supposedly playing for 4 hours even though I've only been streaming for 2, and it's still 12:21, which is what time it actually is. I'm Faulkner, the Violet Pokemon Gym Leader. Won't allow such insults to bird Pokemon. It's on, dude. I really hate sand attack. Dead stream is trying to tell you something. Cherish bird Pokemon. All right, take this. Yeah, you do. Dude, just get a iPhone 7 at like $700. I don't know why they went so high up in price. They were already expensive. Oh, something else that's changed in this game, or in this mod, that makes it easier. Supposedly, I haven't tested it out yet, but the TMs don't disappear. So it's like the new games. Yeah, it's still there. Hello, ZLink. We discovered something about the egg. My assistant is at the Pokemon Center, Violet City. Could you talk to him? Sure. Let's go get Togepi. Yeah. The 6 and 6S is a good size. Poison bar. sent out Onix. Hey, what's up, man? Alright, here's what you missed. I caught a whooper. I named it Whoopee Cushion. It's pretty bad. And I also... we had a fatal casualty. We lost Dwayne. Poor Dwayne. Oh, Dwayne. We can never replace you with, say, The Rock or Johnson. You will forever be missed. All right, is this like Christmas music? What is this? There you go. Yeah, I had noticed that after he fainted, I couldn't heal him with a Pokemon Center, but it seems like putting him in the box heals him, so that's kind of lame. I wish he'd be permadeath. Dwayne died. Now the question is, which one do I want? Do I want The Rock, or do I want Johnson? The That's the real question. I'm thinking the rock. But, yeah. Because a dude randomly had a Chinchou, which is a water and electric type Pokemon. And it doesn't learn Water Gun until way later. But I caught one Geodude in here, and then the other Geodude down here in the grass. Alright, this egg needs to hurry up and hatch. What could it be? A Togepi? Togepi came out of its egg. Scrambled eggs. Egg. Let's see, it's a fairy type. Alright, moving on. Oh, something else I noticed. If you look at the town map, one, they have the Gen 4 map as the town map, which is kind of cool. And there's new locations like Goldenrod Harbor and Bellchime Trail, Glitter Lighthouse, which I'm sure is just the Olivine Lighthouse. But what else? Cliff Edge Gate, Route 47, Cliff Gate, or Cave, Route 48, and Yellow Forest. So, that should be interesting. And Quiet Cave. What else was there? Dark? No, that's where I was. Yeah. It pretty much is. Because you have the Lyra chick, like, helping you out. Oh, that's pretty. Let's just save that and reset the emulator. Storyline, yeah, more or less. Well, it's closer to Gen 4 than Gen 2. All right, moving on. Who are you? ZLink, eh? You want me to make some balls? Nah, I'm good, homie. You can keep your balls to yourself. Anyway, they're at the well, cutting off slowpoke tails for sale. So I'm going to give them a lesson in pain. Alright. Crazy old dude. What do y'all have? Super potion, sweet. Let's get like three of those. Let's get two more. Feel the pain, brother. Hey there, ZLink. The guard up top took off when I shouted at him. Then I took a tumble down the well. I slammed down hard on my back, so I can't move. That sucks. Show them how gutsy you are in my place. Alright, whatever. Who's first? Let's use lame bat. Darn, I was standing guard up top when some old coot yelled at me. Startled me so much that I fell down here. Think I'll vent my anger by taking it out on you. Alright. This dude normally has a Meowth. But it said Meowth's going to town on me. It knows Astonish? Wow. Get in there, the rock. Slowpoke. Let's switch to you. Use Rage one more time. I need more Pokeballs. It is always so absent-minded that it won't react even if its flavorful tail is bitten. I wonder what a slowpoke tail tastes like. Alright, what to name this thing? Slow. Your. Roll. You need to slow your roll. Try to defeat all of y'all. I do like this music though, the Team Rocket music in this game. So, this is like one of my favorite songs in Gen 2. I don't know why. So I gotta enjoy it while I still can before I kill them all. Boom, boom, ba-dum. Rocket Grunt was defeated. You rotten brat. Yeah, whatever. Super potion. Quit taking slow poke tails. If we obeyed you, Team Rocket's rep would be ruined. Metal Claw? Sir Chompy forgot Scratch. What do you want? I'm known as the scariest and cruelest guy in Team Rocket. You interrupt our work, don't expect any mercy. Executive Proton. That's different. Quillfish? Oh, smokescreen. I hate smokescreen. Finally, I hit it. That did nothing. Alright, let's just switch. I'm pretty sure this thing is just gonna use smokescreen the entire match. You did okay today, but wait till next time. Yeah, Team Rock was broken up 3 years ago, but we continued our activities underground. Now you can have fun watching us stir up trouble. Alright. Way to go, ZLink. Team Rocket has taken off. My back's better too. Let's get out of here. Alright. Young Professor Oak. Alright, dude, I think this is where I'm gonna end the stream. Next time I'll face the gym leader, Bugsy, or whoever it is. Yeah, Bugsy. Peace.